Hi, this is Mike Negami, Lean Sigma Black Belt. Let's practice how to write a WBS using an Excel template today. You can download the template that I'm going to show you today from my blog site, econoshift.com. I'll show you how to download it now. There's a link to my blog in the description of my videos. Click it. You'll see this page, which is my site's homepage. And there's a free download button on, so click it, then scroll down on this page, and you'll see WBS template. Click on download in blue, you'll receive an Excel file of the template. Since this file uses VBA, aka macros, when you open the file, Excel security will disable it. You have to enable the VBA by clicking the buttons Enable editing and enable macros. Here are instructions for this template, so please refer to them later. First of all, fill out the upper section in light blue by referring to your project charter. Type your project milestones in the next section. Then you'll see your inputs automatically displayed in the goal statement and its next line below. I'll copy and paste what I typed before. The section in pink is WBS. This shape is very different from a regular upside-down tree-shaped WBS. In order to use space effectively, all items are aligned vertically. The right-angled lines on the left show the respective relationships between items. Now we want to add more items. After double-click on where you want to add another item, this message will appear. Which one would you like to add or delete the line? Enter 1, 2, 3, or 4, then click OK. Items that you can add differ depending on which milestone, deliverable, or task you clicked on. Since I double-clicked on a milestone, I can add any items. Type an integer of 1, 2, 3, and click OK. Since I have 6 milestones, I'll type 1 and click OK. Milestone 2 was entered. I'll repeat the same operation until number 6. I added milestone 7 by mistake. To delete it, double-click on the 7. Type 4 and click OK. Next, consider deliverables of milestone 1 and write them. By the way, there are numbers on the left side of each deliverable and task. PMP calls them WBS ID. 1.1 means deliverable 1 of milestone 1. Also, 1.1.1 means task 1 of deliverable 1 of milestone 1. In this template, each time you add an item, all WBS IDs are updated automatically. It is a real pain in the neck if you have to do it by yourself. When you add an item later, you have to change all subsequent WBS IDs. Now I want to add another task for deliverable 1. Double-click on the task and type 3. Then another task line will be added. Repeat this work breakdown on all the milestones. If you have some items that you are not sure what to type for at this moment, just make a line and leave it blank. Lastly, type the responsible person's name and the completion target date for each task in the light green section. Then your initial WBS is completed. Then share this WBS with your team and adjust or modify it if needed. I use this WBS in schedule management and rotate a PDCA cycle in my project. In the check phase, you can record each task's progress in this template. Select one cell in the progress percentage section. Then you'll see a list button. You can enter your progress percentage by clicking the button. Today, we practiced making a WBS. It's not only for official projects, but also you can use a WBS in your daily work. Please try to utilize a WBS to your work with this template. Thank you very much for viewing. If you like my videos, simply click the subscribe button. Thanks.